swear to God, that's not us. We were back here.
This was left over here?
In the dining room on the floor, right where you have your key to.
Silk
stockings, whatever we can get to make this thing come out. We think it's a female, possibly. So we can go two ways on this. Female, old person, like Jeannie's theory. Okay, we'll do things like, I'm dirty, I'm filthy. I'll bring a walker and a wheelchair. We'll see if we can get any kind of thing like that. Or we can go with the elemental thing. We'll use a flame, we'll use some dirt.
And not to use these outlets, and I quit, and I felt much better afterwards.
But it's enjoy. This here is incredibly nuts high.
I know.
So should we do it inside there?
It comes around this way, to this outlet.
That's a phone jack I'm touching.
I know, but come to this outlet right over here. There's an outlet right back there, behind there. Right, you see it?
There's somebody crying.
Really?
Oh.
If I do it.
Dear, what can I do to help you?
What do we do?
Oh, my head is just
angling. What can I do to help you?
My body's telling you. I need treatment.
Shall I help? Oh, no. She's
okay.
Going.
Okay, she's fine.
She's going.
Good. Come on, Margie.
Go, Margie.
Okay.
Go. Oh, man. Woo.
Did she go? Oh. She go? Okay.
Filming at the Weldon house. This is going to be the final investigation. I'm just going to do a quick run through. This is the kitchen right here. Here to the left is that small room where we capture the cackle. We'll go in there later on. It's just some quick daytime shots. And of course, this is the room where Andy's body was found dead. He was shot dead. This is where it happened. Room right here by the front, the living room. And this, I guess, is the den where the cackle was captured 5 years ago. I don't know if we have some lighting over here. There we go. There was one room we could never have access to, and that was Sam's room. And this is it. Never ever stepped inside this place before. And this was where Sam always confined himself. stepped in this place before today. There's this closet right there. I remember this being carpeted the last time we were here. There's me. Like, she did leave toilet paper for us. The little master closet, and then the Joy's room. All way back here, and then the front door again, and then back to the main room, the living room, the chimney. Chimney's two-sided, I guess. There's another chimney right here. Yeah, it's a big chimney that goes on both sides. So Joy's brother was here during the day. He'd moving a lot of the stuff out of the garage. We may have access to the garage today, but the house is emptied out.
Pablo, the last time we were here was 5 years ago to the day.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. We still are a group called Martinez Paranormal.
Mm-hmm.
I was an investigator in training.
Yeah.
You were the talent. And we did this thing where we got on the floor, we were asking questions, so we got a really compelling piece of audio footage.
Yep, I remember that. It was actually, that was like one of the very first significant evidence we ever got of the paranormal. Well, when we started the group, that was
played the EVP. So you hear Scott talk in the beginning, and then you hear Joy and Jeanine say, oh, what's that, what's that? And then Scott will start like explaining a little bit, and then you'll hear.
All right.
And you can't miss it. Guarantee you won't miss
okay.
it.
Ooh, I think I brought something in my truck. I'll bring it back. I think I brought Andy Kondrick's toy.
What's that? What's that?
The inductive coil. Just in the sale book.
Yeah, sure.
So it screams through it.
Wow.
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. What was that?
Whoa.
Now, did I have to point that out?
Oh,
I mean,
yeah,
that was pretty
nice.
Distinct.
Okay. All right.
Is that me?
In a word.
No.
It's a cackle, or it's like a witch noise.
Yeah.
So we got this cackle. It sounded like a macaw, but then when we listened to it, it sounded like an old woman.
Yeah, it did.
So you guys come over to my pad, and you go, hey, we got to check this out. We got to play this. And it freaked me out, because we didn't hear it with the naked ear.
No. But when we heard it over in the audio, it was like really loud.
It was louder than just like a class A EVP.
No.
Like a yell.
Yeah.
But I do believe that there's sacred parts of houses and stuff. Now, Joy romanced this thing. We know that she did. She just so wanted it to be accepted in the paranormal world. And we get that. And it's nothing bad with that.
Yeah, daily she would be sending me EVPs from this house.
This place is great.
Ever since we first investigated this house, daily I would get EVPs from her saying, look what I caught today. Look what I caught today. Listen to this. And there would be all kinds of stuff that she just becomes so obsessed with it, and daily she's investigating. So.
But here at the Weldon House, it was a secret. There's an island that not too many people knew about.
It's because Joy was living here, and it's something that never really got big, but it has a lot of activity. And now, after 5 years, she's about to give up the lease, and she invited us over for one last time.
Thank you.
place one of them in a different room while we're doing a session in this room. You guys pick a room. There's
let's do the one. Let's do one of the bedrooms, maybe.
You know what? Sam's room is open for the first time. We never remember how we
never got to go in there.
I'll stick one of these in Sam's room and we'll hit record.
That's pretty far.
So while we're here doing EVP session, this will record over there. So we're going to put that right now.
Should have been to go, bro.
See, if you want to follow me, George,
put on your head.
5 years ago, we investigated, but we never got to step inside Sam's room. This was the room that was just completely blocked off because Sam would just be in here every time we do an investigation. He'd just be in this room, just barricading himself, keeping himself away from people. When we had that live event, he stayed in here the whole time. He never even came out. So we don't know what's been going on in this room, but we're going to have a digital voice recorder running while we do our EVP session in the formal dining room. Let's get this thing away. So they're playing some music over there currently. Alright, EVP session. This is the recorder that's inside Sam's room. Let's get back over there and see what they're doing. Alright, so the recorder's running in Sam's room.
Do you believe that there could possibly be a demonic entity here?
What do you think? You think there was maybe something?
I have a way to test it if you guys want to try it.
Let's try it.
Yeah.
It's
you have a ghost app or something?
No, I don't believe in that, but I think I have something that it won't really, it doesn't do any damage, but it could possibly draw something out demonic. It's
okay.
It's been proven to not work. Right.
To not work.
Our EVP session in the formal dining room, session one.
Drawing out a demonic entity, possibly. Is anybody in here with us? Car.
What is that?
I don't know, but it sounds like I'm coming to airplane mode here, sorry. The reason we play that is to lighten up the investigation at first. For the record, we have a house behind us, and we have a house that way. The noise is coming from that way, and that's the street, right? So 5 years ago, we were sitting here, and we were talking about Andy Kopic, and he had an inductive coil. I said, you said, well, where is it? I said, it's in the trunk of my car, and I'll go get it, or something like that. Well, this is the inductive coil. If this bothers you, or you want to come near it and touch the end of it, it might give us an idea that you're here and you would like to communicate with us. I'll tell you what, there's a lot of electricity here.
Remember the last time we were here, how you tested it out and there was a lot of...
Right here.
along the walls and everything?
This is an open wire funnel with a wire net. That is all EMF, you guys. That come out.
And that is bad, right? To have so much EMF in one room?
Well, I guess they call it EMF cage. When you're surrounded by EMF,
you get that nauseous feeling.
Right.
It's funny because I was going to comment about that. Like, when I walk into this room, it just feels a lot heavier than the rest of the rooms. It just does. It just feels heavier.
We went came in this room because we were sitting in that room and we kept feeling like we were being watched or something in this room. Mm-hmm. You see, it's got a lot of electromagnetic field. All the walls. And it's so high. Here's a light bulb. That's as high as you're gonna get it, right?
Wow.
In this house. So that's an open wiring box. Light switch. Right here. If I didn't even believe a K2 meter or anything that maybe even the compass. Well, actually, the compass would be the only thing that works. So what we do, we've got a compass here, and we'll point it towards north. And then if we can get it to move around, because it won't, it'll only stay the same. You know, it won't.
Yeah.
So let's just see if we can do this. Put my glasses on the scene. So I'll point this compass towards north, so the needle on the compass won't move. We'll just keep an eye on it. And you can kind of see the compass, it's kind of bouncing around right now. You can see when we put something with electronic field by it, how it'll move.
So that,
no, it's still spinning because of the battery, yeah.
Okay, so I switched on the air conditioning. Was there a change in the readings by the compass when I switched on the air conditioning?
So the compass is a good way that we can read the room to know if there's anything changing as well. I'm kind of glad we're not using K2 meters and stuff like that tonight. The last time we came here, we did. So if you guys would just do want to do a quick breezy EVP session and see if we can get it to...
Let me complete this one, EVP session, and offer you this afterwards, of course, but we're going to do a quick burst one that way we can review it right away. So, you ready?
Hi, my name is Scott.
Pablo.
Jesus.
George.
We'll do a quick question, wait for a couple seconds in between. Do you believe in God?
What is your name?
Are you evil?
Is this your house?
Are you glad that Joy has moved?
Do you want us to leave?
Are you unhappy? Something over there. Did you see something, George?
No,
I'm hearing something over there.
No, it's those...
Did the air conditioning vent hit you?
Yep.
Okay. And we got that piece of... We got some of the fur that's just sliding around the floor right there. That's not pretty.
Where is the fur from?
There was so many cats here during the time that Joy was living here, and so there's a huge collection of fur around the house.
Do you like cats?
Are you angry?
Did you get burned?
Do you want to leave this place?
Do you know who Mark and Debbie Constantino are?
Hear that? That was outside.
Can we play it back?
Yeah, let's play it back. Let me get the good speaker and end the EVP session.
What the hell was that?
What was that? They reacted to Mark and Debbie Constantino.
Let's cut that and send that to them. If we can. Right away.
ASAP.
This second.
ASAP.
Hey, well, if we can do that, are we not allowed to do that? My name is Scott. Paolo. Jesus. George. And we have a quick question. Wait for a couple seconds in between. Do you believe in God?
house. Are you glad that Joy's moved?
Do you want us to leave?
Are you unhappy? Something over there, did you see something yours?
No, I'm not sure. I keep hearing something over there.
No, it's still going on.
Where are your minds?
Like, did the air conditioning done to you?
Yep.
Okay. And we got that piece of... We got some of the fur that's just sliding around the floor right there.
Where is the fur from?
There was so many cats here during the time that Joy was living here, and so there's a huge collection of fur around the house.
Do you like cats?
Are you angry?
That's me itching.
Did you get burned?
Hear that?
There's that noise.
It was cats.
No, it was outside. Can you play that?
What was that? I heard this, like, something.
Hear that?
Got a gun and some motherfucking ghosts.
Yeah, paranormal, fuck.
Investigation, fuck yeah.
Alright, so we got an SP7 spirit box running. It's scanning 3 a.m. frequencies and what's this doing session with this thing on, so we'll see what can pick up.
Okay.
Any voices responding to our questions or whatever.
Okay.
And I'll be running this to, so we have a record.
Look at my socks, for the record. That's what I'm walking around on.
Shit, that was over 2 seconds.
Is it really
just took them off.
They were white.
It's over. Dirty it is in here. Sorry, Joy. All right, so.
Oh, yeah.
We are recording.
Fuck yeah.
So, it's Scott, if you want to leave.
Do you want to go home?
What?
Fuck yeah.
What was that? That was in the kitchen.
It was one of the fucking bottles.
Can you do that again for us?
Wait. He didn't say leave.
I think it said leave.
Do you want us to leave?
Run.
Run?
Leave?
Run? Leave?
Make us leave.
Everybody's saying leave.
Did anybody get scared just for a second? Did you guys feel any for feeling a dread? Do something and we'll leave. We know that you're here, you talk to Joy, we love Joy, you love Joy. Can you talk to us like you talk to Joy?
Are you glad she's gone and out of the house?
There's something else in there other than that voice. Do you hear it?
Well, what are you hearing?
Do you want to be our friend?
Who are you?
Now, Joy has recorded so much in this house, and you have spoken. Can you speak to us?
Thank you.
Do you remember us? We were here 5 years ago. Can you say our names?
What?
Disregard that. We're getting that every time.
Andy, can you speak to us? We know what happened to you. We know you died here. Do you remember who killed you? Continue AM sweep. Let's switch this on.
Well, we're not leaving now. Does that make you angry?
Nope.
Are you pissed off?
The bowling ball, we want you back over here in this room.
Can you knock louder?
Talks to Joy. We don't have a female to offer you to talk to, but if you give us some sort of sign, touch one of us, whisper in our ear, we will call a female for you to talk to on the phone.
Yep.
Man, I'm getting the creeps.
Me too.
My creeps is ascended this way. But it could be just dark door.
These are a little bit of headlights.
I'm really on the edge right now.
Really?
Absolutely. But I've got dark doorway syndrome going on.
Yeah, you
did.
Yeah,
so that's just messing. DDS.
What is inside ever. I
have the camera pointing in there right now.
You.
talk to Brenda.
Something was walking closer.
Yeah.
Right, what he said. Well, really, what he said, if you want this, come on up. Remember what you said?
I don't know.
And it was like, well, if you want this, come on over here. And you hear that.
Come on out here if you want to talk to Brenda. Come on out here if you want to talk to Brenda. Come on out here if you want to talk to Brenda.
To that?
Yeah, it's in that room.
Let's call it back. Let's do this. Why don't, if you want Brenda to come over here and fuck you, you're going to have to come in here and give us a sign. Somehow. Walk closer to us. I can get her on right back on the phone right now for you. But you gotta give us some sort of sign. If it made you uncomfortable, also give us a sign. Brenda's a beautiful young lady. Very, very smart. I heard footsteps or something shuffling.
See, it could have been from outside, but it wouldn't have been that loud.
No, because the thing was is that when I heard it, it changed how do you say, like, the flooring changes. So it sounded like it was on wood, then it sounded like it was on cement. Which meaning it went from the room in the hallway to that outside right here.
Do you want her to come back? Come on. I know you're right here, man. And I know something really, really bad happened to you. And I know you can't feel the touch of a woman like where you're at. But if you can give us some sort of sign, we're gonna leave here. And we're never gonna come back. If you could touch us or whisper to us or tell us something, I don't do the gadgets and all that. You gotta talk to us. We're really sorry what happened to you. But if we want us to help you get somebody to move you on, we're going to have validation that you're actually here.
That was me.
Show yourself to us, please. We're not going to put it on computer sites and things to make us look grandioso. We just want to know how we can help you and what we can do to further your journey to the other side. There's a God out there and he's waiting for you if you're stuck here. And if it's just us saying, move into the kingdom of light, or Jesus Christ, welcome this man or woman into your kingdom, and then you could go, then go. But if you're stuck here for a reason, you gotta tell us how we can help.
Session. We're all going to be in Sam's room, so this recorder will be by itself here in the formal dining room.
Sis, lock that side door. Make sure that side door is locked. We don't have any unfortunate guests.
Locking it tight. Okay, so we're locked in here. And we can come in. Let's head up to Sam's room. That static cam running. Or we pick up this one.
Are you hearing
me? Scott, can you show us what that thing is for? Going to film
this right here? This is called the Eco Box. And it is, there's a lot of apps that are on the web or on Google Play and other things that talks about this. They're like ghost radars and this kind of stuff, you know, and they're not real. This thing right here is similar like the Frank's Box, the Hack Shack, the SP7, where it scans through not just, sketching also the files on your phone, little pieces of stuff on your phone, so it grabs any kind of information it has. It has four channels, but what I like to do, and we're going to play just like we did the other one, we're going to enable the See, you see right now, doing the channel blend, all four channels, and let's just start it. And ask a question to it, Paula.
Are you in here with us?
Come on out here if you want to talk to Brenda.
Where you grab me?
This is for you.
It's been a crazy night so far.
It has been.
What do you think about the Weldon House tonight?
There's some interesting stuff. I don't know. There's kind of stuff that we have to kind of go back and look at, but there's just being there, there's some interesting stuff already, so.
Weirdest things that happened tonight, we left the digital recorder in a separate room, the room that we don't usually go into, and we got a breath. Right when we left it there, it was almost like, this guy's again kind of an anxious sort of, no, God, not this again, breath. We proceeded to go in there after a while, after we went over the recording. We sat down and we kept hearing things. Now it's on the other side of the house, so I don't know if it's just playing tricks with us or we're just kind of screwing ourselves up. We're going to do a couple more hours here. We're going to go in a little bit deeper and see if we can find anything there. We had a woman call in and talk provocative to the spirit, and we heard something down the hall, so we chased that down again to no avail.
Tim, we're still got a few more hours left. I mean, what do you think? What do you think, we're still going to catch something big tonight? You think maybe they're just waiting for us? to...
I don't know. We'll find out.
It's upside down, but don't worry, it's gonna be right side. Okay, so Scott went home, so it's just the three of us now. And I'm going to do something that nobody should even try in a haunted house like the Weldon house.
Yeah.
Is go inside by yourself with the lights completely off, just me and the camera. There's also a static cam running out there in the house, down the hallway facing towards Joy's room. So that camera will be running, capturing whatever. And no, there's still like fireworks going on out here. It's just craziness out here. You guys are gonna hang out here for a bit?
Yep.
And I'm gonna be in there. As you can see, the lights are completely off. It's just gonna be me in complete darkness inside the Weldon house. So let's see what happens. Wish me luck.
Luck?
I'll lock the door.
We'll lock the door. Lock down.
Lock down? Actually, I'll just keep the keys.
Okay.
Yeah, you did.
All right, here we go.
All right.
Now, remember, you guys stay out here. Try to keep it quiet.
All right.
If you guys want to talk, you can go by the cars. All right. Switching to night vision. Lights are completely off. This is going to be interesting. All right, closing the door. Now, I never stepped inside this house by myself. This is the very first time. There's absolutely nobody in here. And that, you can hear that's a creaking of the floor. Let me lock the focus on this, because the focus will just go crazy. All right. Now, of course, this is the room where we caught the cackle. And we caught a bit of evidence tonight already with Scott here and everybody. I'm gonna see if I can go around the house, see what happens. Let me grab a recorder, have it on the table right here. Okay. Session. To whoever's in here, there's nobody in here but me. 5 years ago we were here, we caught a loud voice. We call it the cackle. We don't know what caused that, or even what it was exactly. We call it the cackle because it was loud, and it sounded sort of like a bird, or maybe an old lady. Can you tell me who that was? That's creaking on the floor that you hear. Can you please show yourself? Showing the recorder because I want everybody to know that I'm not messing with the recorder or fiddling with it to contaminate it or any way. You can see that I'm just holding it still. Tell me what your name is. I'm the only one inside the house. And Joy's been living here for years, but she's finally leaving. Are you happy that she's leaving? Some noise coming, probably from outside. I'm gonna play it back. Inside the house by myself. I'm very vulnerable right now because I got no backup. Was found. It was right here on the floor. Now, air conditioning is running, so we have all that noise. Let me switch it off just so I can do a session right here. Let me get back up here, hit something. This is the thermostat right here. Just switch it off. step. Okay. It'll switch completely off in a little bit. I'm gonna do a session. You can see the backyard right here. Okay, once again, the recorder. All right, I'm in what used to be patio area. It's now enclosed. I think this used to be outside. It was the patio area. You can see some of the roof of the patio still here. That's just enclosed. They just added this wall to completely enclose it. All right, complete quiet here now. Andy, this is where you died. Can you please say something to me? Somebody killed you. Was it over a girl? Is that why they killed you? Were you involved in something? Maybe gangs? Please talk to me, Andy. I want to know what happened. This noise came from right above me. Please talk to me, Andy. I have this recorder right here. You can talk and it'll pick up your voice. You remember me. I was here 5 years ago. Joy brought me here. Told me about what happened to you. You want to say something and show the world that you're still here and that you're angry or sad? Please let us know. This is your chance because we won't be back ever again. We won't ever come back to this place. So this is the last chance to talk to us.
You remember me? I was was here 5 years ago. Joy brought me here. Told me about what happened to you. You want to say something and show the world that you're still here and that you're angry or sad, please let us know. This is your chance because we won't be back ever again. We won't ever come back to this place. So this is the last chance to talk to us.
I'm gonna do one more session. Let me grab something first. I need to get to the kitchen. I'm gonna avoid that step right there. Now this is the SB7 spirit box. I used it tonight already. Got some pretty interesting stuff, so I'll try it out. Let me switch it on. I'll try FM. This might be loud.
Thank you.
I'm gonna stop her for a bit. Andy, or whatever spirit's here, can you talk to me through this radio? As it scans through the radio stations, I'm gonna keep it quiet until it gets back to the empty band, running on FM. Whoever spirit's here, please let me know if you want me to leave. I'm in here by myself. Just let me know if you want me to leave. Joy says this house is really haunted, and she's been collecting so many EVPs in this place. Voices that you guys were imprinting on recorders for her. This is your chance to really tell me what you want to say. I saw something right here. It was some sort of light. That freaked me out right here. I don't know if I captured it on camera, but that's kind of freaky. Is something there? Are you here? Are you trying to show yourself? It was really bright. It was just right here in this area. This is the area where we caught the cackle. Very active part of the house. You know, I'm gonna leave soon. And if you don't want to talk to me, that's fine. But I still know that you're here. Please say something. Okay, I'm gonna leave now. Thank you for cooperating with me. Hopefully we caught something on our camera's audio or something. But that was freaky. I did see something right here, something lit up. And it's pretty freaky being in this house all by myself. See if any other guys would actually be willing to do that. We're in EVP session in the patio room where Andy died. I'm gonna put the recorder right around the spot where he was found. So, let me grab one of the chairs. The chair over here.
the recorder right around the spot where he was found. So, let me grab one of the chairs. The chair over here. So it was a different mood that night. And of course, we were new at paranormal investigating still. You know, this is one of our first cases. And 5 years have passed, and to be back here, it's kind of weird. You still hear fireworks going on out there. So when I was in here by myself, I was asking Andy, you know, if he wants to talk to us, you know, because we know that this is where he died. Mm-hmm. He wanted to say something.
And make his presence known.
Because 5 years ago, we reenacted your murder. Did you like it? Did it make you feel good? That we understood how you died? That you're not forgotten? So it's 11:19, so we're already past that time where he died. But she said that around that time you always hear gunshots or something, but
yeah, I know was that. Was that taken into account for, what's it called?
Daylight savings.
You know what? We don't know.
We don't know exactly what month.
So if it could be daylight savings.
It's around that time.
You're right, because it would be around 10:15 if it wasn't for daylight savings. So let's say it is. And this is the time that you died. Please come out and hang out with us. We're not afraid of you, and you shouldn't be afraid of us. We heard you walk around earlier when Scott was asking you to come over and she had that woman on the phone. I think you actually liked that. You liked that kind of attention.
Outside.
Yeah. I came from in there. Now there's no cats in here anymore. We had cats last time we were here, so every time we hear noise from another room, we think it has to be a cat, but there's no cats in here. So you're over there, why don't you come over here? Come on, Andy, come join us.
Are you scared?
The noise is coming from over there. Something's going on over there.
Are you in the kitchen? Andy, is that you? If it's not Andy, make a noise.
You know there's something out there, whether it's Andy or maybe another spirit. Can you come over here? It's like movement just all around over there. There's all kinds of movement. Just sit back and listen. Knocking noise. Let's just sit back and listen. What's that knocking noise? I remember the asthma dog that was here when we first investigated. He passed away not too long after we did that first investigation. I wonder if his dog spirit's here. Oh. And so happens we have a dog barking. Coming from out there.
He hasn't barked all night.
That's fine. Not all night until we mentioned
a dog.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. Are you a little puppy? A little dog? It's all over. It's just noises coming from all over the house except here.
Okay, my IR is starting to dim out a little bit.
All right, go ahead and change them.
Now I'm freaked out.
Why?
I don't know. It could be that dog kind of...
I think I would have remembered hearing that dog.
It's 33. No, too far.
Strange.